Ayahuasca is hard to spell. Ayahuasca. Maybe I should grab some, that would be easier. Hey everybody, Trace here for DNews. In 2015, the United States got its first legal ayahuasca church. It promised to provide ayahuasca spiritual healings to members at a price. It was quickly shut down a year later, with skeptics calling the church a cult and a scam. But there may be an actual benefit to using ayahuasca in the first place. Ayahuasca is commonly used by indigenous communities in healing ceremonies in the Amazon rainforest. It's a tea that produces hallucinatory effects after consumed, but many consider it a miracle drug, treating a number of disorders, including depression. But is this scientifically accurate, or are we just drinking up some kind of ancient placebo Kool-Aid? Ayahuasca is traditionally made from the leaves of a shrub and the stems of a vine. When digested together, they introduce a fairly famous compound called DMT into the blood, which eventually finds its way to the brain and causes hallucinations. But DMT has a not-so-famous partner, harmine, which, in addition to hallucinations, has antidepressant qualities. And there have been studies to back up ayahuasca as a treatment for depression. Most recently, one study published in PeerJ exposed human neuroprogenitors, cells that are capable of becoming neurons, to harmine, resulting in a 71.5% increase in human neural cells. This is similar to other antidepressants, which cause what's called neurogenesis. But this isn't the first study of its kind. There have been several studies done on ayahuasca, usually with small sample sizes, like really small. But because there aren't that many in the overall scientific literature, we thought they were worth mentioning. One study with 6 volunteers found improvements within hours in people's moods after drinking ayahuasca. Typical antidepressants could take weeks. Another study had 3 women with depression drink ayahuasca. Their symptoms decreased for 2 weeks afterwards. And in a 2015 PLOS ONE study, they linked the ayahuasca's altered state of consciousness to decreased activity in parts of the brain associated with depression. There's even a meta-analysis of various studies on ayahuasca and its antidepressive effects from the past 25 years. They concluded that ayahuasca is a useful pharmacological tool for the treatment of mood disorders. It's actually pretty difficult to conduct studies on this substance, considering DMT is classified as a Schedule 1 drug by the US Drug Enforcement Agency, banning it from medicinal use. Many of the studies we mentioned here happened in countries where it's allowed for religious purposes, including Brazil and Peru. In which case, researchers would have to wait for the perfect series of events, volunteers who experience depression and who are willing to drink ayahuasca. As for larger controlled studies outside of religious exception, we may just have to wait a bit longer. As always, more research is needed. What other psychedelic drugs do scientists think might have medicinal benefits? Find out in this video here with my girl, Kristen Conger. What other science questions do you have about stuff like this? Let us know down in the comments. Make sure you subscribe for more DNews, and thanks for tuning in.